Join me as we listen to Diet Eman, one of the leaders of the Dutch underground during the Second World War, as she shares the story of her amazing life and how it follows right in the pages of the Bible. And the stories come alive as we hear her life and the Bible's life come together as one story. In terms of the people that you worked with, you know, did you think a lot of people, I mean, their faith grew tremendously during this time, their faith in the Lord? Would you say that the people on the farms, the people in the resistance, your own faith, I mean, it had to be growing every day, every second you had to trust the Lord.
But you know, it is the Netherlands and we have stiff lipped. So, I mean, they don't really talk about their faith.
So they were kind of quiet
about
it. They
live it, yes. Okay. But they don't. And that has changed, and that's what I love about America, because in the Netherlands, you did it, but you didn't talk about it.
You didn't say anything.
No.
Yeah.
And it's good that, I mean, the outsiders should see what you do out of love to God.
Yes, exactly.
And sharing.
You know, the thing that surprises me is that period of 2 years when you were on the run before you were arrested, and literally, almost, how were you moving every other night? I mean, were you moving regularly?
Sometimes I stayed 2 days or 3 days.
You stay two to three days? Yes.
But that's what I love, because David was on the run for Saul.
Yeah.
I loved the Psalms of David because I felt the same, you know.
So you were kind of like,
how can you do this?
You were kind of like David running from Saul. I mean, every day, every 2 or 3 days, you might move to another place.
I love Psalm 27. The Lord is my light and my salvation. And then later, he put me on a rock and he hid me in his tent. And that's what he literally did with me.
So literally the Psalms, and particularly David's life, really came to life for you in an amazing way, because you really were a fugitive. I mean, in your own country, you were always on the run, trying to continue to hide. Did you find that some of the people were very scared to have you in their house?
Then they didn't take you.
And they just wouldn't take you. So how did you find people? I mean, you're on the run for 2 years.
Well,
how do you find
farmers,
people?
Farmers, you know, they knew each other. And if you say, I came at one address and I knew they were wonderful Christians. And they had said, because sometimes an address became dangerous and then we had to take them out. But where do you then go? Because the people who were willing to take them had already. And I remember that they said, well, that couple is very Christian, and go there, because I was with a shaky case that I thought I have to take that guy out. And I went, no, we want nothing to do with. And I was in my heart so angry. And I thought, how can you, as a Christian, say no? Later I heard they had already Jews.
Oh, they already had people there, some of them,
I was so young, I didn't even think of that possibility.
Yeah. As I reflect on Diet's life and the amazing things that happened to her and how she saw the Bible come alive for her as she went through her trials and her suffering, I think that the deeper message perhaps for all of us in listening to Diet is that as we go through our life, whatever the challenges, whatever the struggles, there's going to be a place in the Bible that's going to speak right to our situation. Diet's story and being on the run for over 2 years from the Nazis was very much, as Diet reflected, a story of David running from Saul. And I think that connection to Scripture was something that gave her a sense of meaning and purpose and interpretive narrative to the things that she was going through. I want to encourage all of us here as we listen to Diet and think about our own lives to find that place in the Bible, those stories that really God has put there to speak to our life, our circumstances, and the things that we are going through to give us perspective, hope, and meaning in whatever we're going through.